spend about 15 to 20 minutes going through our pranayama practice and then easing right into a meditation. So make yourself comfortable. You may want a blanket or a shawl or a sweater across the shoulders if you get cool. Now we're going to talk about apagraha today. And this is another yama from the yamas and niyamas of the eight limbs of yoga from Patanjali's Yoga Sutras. So these are the ways that we can improve our quality of life by things that we can dedicate ourselves to in a daily practice, hopefully. So apagraha is non-possessiveness, and I think it relates really well to pranayama and to meditation. The ability to let go, especially letting go of any sort of expectations or reward for your practice. Some sort of, you know, when you do something because you want something to come out of it, it's really what we're trying to avoid. We just want to do the practice because it in itself is the reward. The practice is the reward, not what you get at the end of the practice. So, we will talk more about that later, but for now we're going to go and get started with our pranayama. So we'll start with our Kapalabhati. Hands can be on the knees and the thighs, palms up, palms down, mudra if you prefer to have a mudra for your hands. This one's nice, Dhyana mudra, thumb and index finger together, palms open. And we'll go through three rounds of, let's do 55 today and see how that goes. So the cueing is inhale fully, exhale fully, half an inhale, and then you start the forceful exhales with the pumping action in the low belly. Remember that we're thinking primarily about the exhale, that a little puff of air out through the nose, and that slight pulling in and out of the low belly for the exhale. Inhale is passive. So we'll do 55. You just count them out yourself. Try not to go too fast, otherwise the belly tends to stay quite firm and it's really hard to soften to let the breath come in naturally. So it can't be too fast. If you have a clock that has the dots that blink for each second, it's a really nice way to get a steady pattern or rhythm to your breath. Otherwise, just reminding yourself not to get going too fast and try not to make the low belly pumps too forceful. And then after our Kapalabhati, we'll move right into Anuloma Viloma. And I think today we'll try something just a little bit different. We're going to be inhaling for 5, holding for 10, exhaling for 10. So it's a slightly different ratio. We'll just see how that feels. And we'll go through 2 guided, and then we'll go on our own so that you have a chance to see how it feels to be guided. And then you can continue the pattern on your own, or you can modify it or adjust it for what you need today. And then right after that, we'll slide right into our meditation. All right, let's get started. Nice tall seat. Full breath in. Full breath out. Half an inhale to start. Exhale, second round, 55, half an inhale to start. last round of 55. Half an inhale to start. Moving into Anuloma Viloma, so our alternate nostril breathing. Left hand still with the mudra of choice. Right hand now comes to be blocking the nostrils. So you can do Vishnu's mudra. Two fingers down the thumb pad, the other fingers are for blocking. So again, we'll do inhaling for 5. Holding and retaining the breath with the bandhas for 10. Exhaling for 10. So we're only holding the bandhas on while we're retaining the breath. As soon as we start to exhale, of course, they soften and release. The bandhas are very subtle and simple. So it's slight pulling up of the low belly, the action of like stopping your pee, and then tucking the chin. So we're creating this vessel or container of locks holding the prana or energy in the body. Inhaling nice and slow and smooth, quite quiet. Exhaling again, slow and smooth. And it's that first initial release of the exhale that we want to pay particular attention to. We want it to not be like a gasp or a quick release. We want it to be very slow and easy. So there's effort involved there, but it shouldn't cause any strain. Let's get started. Hand up in front of the nose or the face. Full breath in to start, just cleaning out. Full breath out, block the right, inhale left, om 1, om 2, om 3, om 4, om 5, lock and hold, apply the bandhas, om 3, om 4, om 5, om 6, om 7, om 8, om 9, om 10, exhale right, om 1, om 2, om 3, om 4, om 5, om 6, om 7, om 8, om 9, om 10. Inhale right. Om 1, om 2, om 3, om 4, om 5. Lock and hold. Om 1, om 2, om 3, om 4, om 5, om 6, om 7, om 8, om 9, om 10. Exhale left. Om 1, om 2, om 3, om 4, om 5, om 6. Om 7, Om 8, Om 9, Om 10. Inhale left. Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4, Om 5. Lock and hold with the bandhas. Om 3, Om 4, Om 5, Om 6, Om 7, Om 8, Om 9, Om 10. Exhale right. Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4, Om 5, Om 6, Om 7, Om 8, Om 9, Om 10. Inhale right. Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4, Om 5. Lock and hold. Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4, Om 5, Om 6, Om 7, Om 8, Om 9, Om 10. Exhale left. Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4, Om 5, Om 6, Om 7, Om 8, Om 9, Om 10. Continue on your own, inhaling 5. Lock and hold 10. Exhale right 10. Inhale right 5. Lock and hold 10. exhale left 10. And continuing on your own. Finish the round that you're on by ending with an exhale through the left. And then just come to sit with your palms either up or down, eyes gently closed. You can flutter the eyes open and just take a moment to move around. And we'll move right into our meditation. And if meditation is new for you, then this idea of apagraha will be a really nice thing to sort of keep your focus on. So it's the idea of not clinging to things, we always have these ideas of how things should be or look or feel or what the result should be. And it just becomes this huge burden that's unnecessary. So Apagraha teaches us to just let go. Just do whatever it is that you're going to do for the joy of doing it, and not worry too much about how it looks to others, how it should feel in comparison to others, or what you should be rewarded with at the end. Just do it because it's a joy in itself. So for our meditation, choosing either an image, a person, a phrase, so a mantra, whether it's a word or a short phrase, anything that you can keep your attention on. And it doesn't have to be contemplation, which is different than meditation. Just something to kind of have as like an anchor. And know that you don't have to be in any particular position to meditate. If you start to get, you know, irritated by a pulling sensation in the upper back because you're needing to move, then just shift your position. Quite often, ending up with hands resting on the knees is nice because you can round and yet you're still supported, you're still upright. That's one of my favorites. Or having your back against a wall or sitting in a chair. And you can continue with your meditation even if you do have to move around and adjust. And yeah, so if it's new to you, then I would suggest just resolving to stay seated for the time that we're going to do this together. And that's enough. So just resolving to, I'm just going to stay here, I'm just going to sit. I will time it, so it'll be a 10-minute meditation. And it'll either go by super slow or super fast for you. I like to sit with my hand in a mudra. My favorite one is to simply rest the hands on each other in the lap. And you might have something that feels good for you and just trust your instincts that that's the right one. And what's nice to start with before you go into whatever it is you're going to keep your gentle focus on is, I like two different techniques. Number one is to go through the senses. So closing down the eyes. And then noticing what is your strongest visual sensation. So it could be a color, it could be darkness, it could be the light coming through your eyelids, and then something that's very, very subtle. So going from strong or intense stimulation or information to something that's very subtle. And then moving from eyes perhaps to the nose. So what can you smell? What's the biggest smell that you have around you? And then can you pick up on a smell that's very subtle or faint? Same with the ears. So noticing a sound that is quite loud or easiest to pick up, and then seeing if you can get your hearing to pick up a sound that's very, very quiet or very subtle. And then same with the taste. Can you taste whatever is in your mouth, whether it's the remnants of a drink or a food or a cleansing technique that you are doing? And then finally, touch. So where is the biggest sensation for you? Where is the most subtle sensation for you? So for example, blanket across my legs, hair resting on the nape of my neck. Once you've worked your way through the senses, that should help you to kind of bring yourself to the present moment and stay there. And then can you let all five of your senses be engaged at the same time? So you work them through individually, and then you see if you can hold on to all five of them at the same time. Another practice that I've brought in from shamanic meditation is this idea of the four directions, so north, south, east, west. And what I like to do is I like to think of friends or family that are to the north of me. And usually something, an image or a name or a person pops up really quick. Someone that is to the north, to the south, to the east, to the west. So I just make my way around. Doesn't matter which order you go in, whatever makes sense for you. And I start to circle myself with people that I know or that I care about. And then from that, I find I can sink into whatever it is I'm going to sink into for the time quite easily. So we'll get started. Eyes can be downcast or closed. Hand again in a mudra, comfortable position. Take about a minute to go through the senses, or perhaps to the four different directions, and then we will sit for 10 minutes, and I'll be here with you the whole time. allow your awareness to shift to the breath. And we'll just ease our way into our breath of ease. Well, this is where the breath is very quiet, almost no sound. And it's very comfortable with just a little bit of effort to make the breath slower and longer. So you're inhaling as slow and long as you can. You can choose to have a pause or a hold as your breath is in. And then making that really soft, slow exhale. And again, there's effort to make the breath quieter and longer, but you're comfortable the whole time. We'll just do this for another minute. Allow the breath of ease to dissipate